After 3 years of waiting, the Hallmark Star Wars Storyteller series is complete. It's beautiful, and I want to talk about it. Hey guys and gals, I'm here with a new video. Today it is on the Star Wars Storyteller series by Hallmark. For those of you who don't know what the Storytellers are, they are a series of ornaments, and I think they've recently announced or they're already doing a Harry Potter series. I know there are multiple Storyteller sets, but basically they are ornaments, and they're pretty high quality ornaments. They do cost $39.99 each, so you are paying $40 per ornament. If you do want to pick these up, you can still get them through Hallmark.com. I think the retail locations still have them. How did you get stuck? There we go. Amazon also has them, and you can maybe try eBay to get some discounted prices. I'm not entirely sure, but they are, for the most part, high-quality ornaments that have light and sound features that actually work together. So the more of these you have hung up together, the more of a story it's going to play out. They each have their own individual sounds, their own individual lights, but as you connect them in a chain, you get more of the scene. So for 2017, they gave us the X-Wing, which I think just looks great. R2 is the button for this one. There was Darth Vader's TIE Fighter, which his button is up top there. Again, really nice sculpted detail, kind of what you would expect from Hallmark. I've been getting their ornaments even before I knew that I was getting them, because they're so neat looking. Here's the Falcon, which I think just looks impressive. I absolutely love the Falcon. And so this is an ornament that even if I didn't have the whole Storyteller set, I would want to get this one. It just looks fantastic. And you know what? That's from 2018. I totally had a brain fart. The last one from 2017 was the Death Star, which overall is a little bland, but there is some weathering that the camera might not be picking up, but there is some weathering. It looks really good. It actually has a two-tone light system, whereas the cockpit lights up on each of those. The Falcon, the engines, and the cockpit lights up, and the gun even lights up. This one, you get one color throughout the Death Star and then a different color around the actual, I want to say iris, but the laser. So its button is right there. So that's it for 2017, and the Falcon's button is right there. So onwards for the other 2018 ornament was the regular TIE Fighter. Not too much to really say. It has the same level of detailing as Vader's, the button's still on top. And you're gonna find that when you compare them all together, you kind of get Vader's TIE Fighter and then a slightly different but ultimately same ornament. For 2019, they did the same thing. You got the X-Wing, now you have the Y-Wing. But I gotta say, it's good that the Y-Wing is getting some love. It doesn't seem to get as much merchandise as I would like. I get to push its R2 unit for its button. The cockpit lights up, and I think that's really it for that one. So there's that. And the final 2019 item, the finale for the whole set, is the Star Destroyer, which is honestly my least favorite. When you look at all these guys, the weathering, the detailing, they're really impressive. This one feels kind of lazy, and I'm tempted to dig out my old Star Destroyer ornament that just has a lot more detailing and panels and just work on it. This one, it's solid, it's not heavily detailed, and it just doesn't do a lot for me. It's okay. Yeah, it's all right. It's got Leia's little ship on the bottom. That's you know, whatever. So yeah, that's it. One thing to take note, when you buy these, you will have to get the additional cord to power them. You get the cord, and then there's a little extender bit that has seven total plugs on it. So you can plug seven of these ships into one cord. So seven ships for the full story, seven for the cord. Make sure you get the cord, because it does not come with those. And yeah, like that's kind of where I want to end the review of these. You want to see the full Storyteller aspect and the full light up feature. It's going to be coming up right next, but this is kind of me saying you can go now if you want to, if you don't want to see it. I do recommend picking these up. If you don't want the full Storyteller aspects, just pick out your favorites. The Falcon is fun. It looks great. The X-Wing looks great. The Y-Wing, they all have individual sounds and light-up features. You don't need the full set, but if you want the full story, you do have to cave and spend $40 for each ornament. Like, there's no way around that. But I love them. I say pick them up. You can still get them all from Hallmark.com or Amazon or Hallmark Stars or eBay. Wherever you buy your Hallmark ornaments, they might have them in stock. That's really it. So I thank you guys for watching. I do appreciate it. And I will see you around. Now for the magic part. Woo! It's all right. I can probably angle this a little bit better. You got CX-Wing. We got everybody in frame. So basically, when you plug these guys in for the first time, there's going to be kind of them getting in sync. So we're going to do that now. Oh no, we lost the X-Wing. Luke is down. Luke. There we go. Okay, we're all back. We're good. I'm going to go ahead and turn my light off. And so if you notice, so they all kind of cycle through their own lights. The Death Star has one sound or one light for the base, one around the ring, and they all kind of pulsate and change. You can see it's slowly turning red, and that's going to be green. Green, the cockpit lights up on those. The Falcon, you have the engines at the back lighting up. You have the cockpit lighting up, and you have the turret on top. The Star Destroyer, you have Leia's ship lighting up on the bottom, or kind of like the bay where it's going in, and then the engines on the back light up. So I'm going to let this play out. So I think we got everybody in frame. My little fake rig is sort of working to hang these guys up. All right, let's get started. We're going to be here for a while.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, I don't know how much of that you guys could hear. It got really hectic. The Death Star speaker is definitely the quietest. And I'm really curious how this is going to sound actually in video form. Because even in person, I'm like, I felt like Vader. What? What? So, yeah. It's quite a spectacle on its own. And I think it really is worth it. Just, you're going to be sitting there for a while once you turn it on. And you can see once the storytelling plays out, it does go back to just its general display mode, which I think looks great on its own. Just having those on the tree looks great as I hit my camera. So that was my first time sitting through the whole thing. So that was exciting. But anyway, I thank you guys for watching. I certainly do appreciate it. And I will see you around. Take care.